Everyone, and welcome to my next tutorial where I'll be teaching you a little bit about a service called AWS CloudTrail. So let's dive in. So first of all, what you want to look for is something called CloudTrail. So you can just type here CloudTrail. Okay, so with CloudTrail, we'll be able to track all of the users under our AWS account. We'll be able to track all of their activity. So this includes all of the API calls that they've been making within their various AWS services that they are utilizing. So go and search for that, and I have it here already, along with Amazon S3. So what you can do is you can go ahead and just bookmark the two to your management nav bar here. So go ahead and click on CloudTrail. Okay. So this is particularly useful, as AWS points out to us, for governance, compliance, and auditing our AWS account. So just to give you a bit more structure here. So let's say that you are creating an account for your organization or your company. And once you've created that account for your company, you go ahead and create user accounts for your individual users. So let's say you have about 10 or 20 users at your organization. So they're all issued user accounts. And basically, that's it. They go off, they do their own thing. And let's say some of those users are more on the admin side of AWS, and the rest of your users are maybe developers. So basically, you as the administrator will be able to track all of their API calls. And this is very helpful for auditing, so in case you want to keep records and backup of that. And it's also very useful and helpful in case there's a security issue or someone is trying to do something malicious and basically, you know, they may be using services which they're not allowed to or which they shouldn't have access to or something like that. So it's also very good for security, just to double check and make sure that no user is abusing their privileges that they have been issued. So we can create something called a cloud trail. So try and think in an abstract light. So you are basically, you know, setting up a trail to each user's accounts, each user's user account, because it's in AWS, it's called an IAM user account. So you can track and check all of them with a trail, sort of. So in case you want to know a bit more about pricing, you can go ahead and just open this up here, and it will give you a list of all the pricing for CloudTrail. So you can have a look at this. I won't go into much detail here. So it's quite obvious what's going on here. And you can also see here a basic idea of how it works. So there's a little bit more to it, but I'm just going to keep it very brief for you guys. So what we can do here is create a trail. Okay. Then you can name the trail. So I'm just going to keep it basic and just name this trail management event. So very simple. You can rename it if you'd like. And then go ahead and create your trail. So basically what's going to happen is once our trail has been created, okay, it's going to, of course, have the name management events. It's going to have a home region. This is where we actually created our CloudTrail event. And then it's also going to automatically create an Amazon S3 bucket for us. So it's going to store all of the logs of our API users' calls. So it's going to store all of those logs within an S3 bucket. So this is very similar to what I mentioned earlier on. If you see on my channel, I do have a video on access logging with Amazon S3 buckets. So this is a very similar concept technically. So basically what you're doing here is you're tracking the logs, but it's on a more broad scale this time. So you're tracking the logs of all of your users under your AWS account. Okay, so that is what's going on here essentially. So what we can do technically is go ahead and open this S3 bucket. So I'm just gonna open this in another tab actually. So we can open that up. Okay, this is wait for that to load. Okay, so here we go. So it's under the following here for in our case, and we can see we have a nice folder here within our bucket AWS CloudTrail logs. And we can open that up. And at the moment we can see we have no objects, no logs have been created. So essentially what we can technically do, I'm just going to, for argument's sake, open Amazon S3 here. Okay, I'm gonna open this up. And what I'm going to do is make a few API calls here, basically. So what I can do here is I can create a bucket, for example. So go ahead and create a bucket. So I'm just going to say test-bucket-ct for CloudTrail. Keep the region as default, that's fine. And just create the bucket. Oh, name's taken. Okay, I'm going to say 96 at the end. CT96. There we go. Okay, so just another rule of thumb there. Make sure that you choose something unique. Sometimes you can't always check the first... You don't always know whether something has been taken or not. So try your best to name something as unique as you can so you don't get prompted with that notification. Okay, so I created a bucket. So let's open this up. Okay, let's just click around here. So just making some API calls. Go back to buckets. Let's open this other bucket here. So just, you know, play around, open buckets, close buckets, you know, just generate some API calls. Okay, that's it. That's enough. We can close this. We can actually delete that bucket as well. That might be good. So select that bucket, delete. Let's delete this. So all we're doing here is making API calls. That's all we're doing. So deleting, putting, very simple stuff. Let's close this. And you'll notice we won't see anything just yet. So it does take about 5 to 15 minutes before something does appear in the logs here. So what I'm going to do is just pause the video until I see something here. So about 5 to 15 minutes should be about the time to expect if you're following on along with me. So let's just wait for that. So I'll be back in just a moment. So let's just wait for that. All right, so we're back. So what you can do is just refresh here and you should see some logs here appear. Okay. Now you can see here, these are the API calls that we have been making, and they're all situated in these folders here, as we can see. All right. So this is basically CloudTrail. So being able to track all of the API calls that our users make on AWS, and also any activity that our user, any sort of activity regarding what our users do on AWS is also logged in these folders. Okay. So yeah, that's it, guys. So what you can do, you can just head over to your buckets here just to clear this up. So make sure you first delete the event that you created, the CloudTrail event. So you can just click here and say delete and say yes. Good. Okay, head back to CloudTrail, go to Amazon S3. Now you can delete your AWS CloudTrail bucket. So it'll just say AWS CloudTrail logs. That's more than sufficient. So click on the radio button, go to delete. Now, what we need to do first, of course, is to empty the bucket first. So what I usually do here, it says just type permanently delete. I just usually copy this and paste and say empty. Okay, the bucket has been emptied. We can now say exit. Click on the bucket. Click on the bucket again. Say delete. Now just paste in what you see in the following and delete the bucket. Okay, so the bucket has been deleted as well. Okay, so do bear in mind the pricing so you can just have a rough idea for how much it's going to cost. It shouldn't be too expensive. It's not a very expensive service per se. And there you go, guys. So remember AWS CloudTrail. So this is used to log all of our users' AWS activity. Very helpful for governance, compliance, or any sort of auditing that you may require on your AWS account. All right, guys. So that's it. Thank you so much.